Up to this point in our process costing series, we've discussed process costing within the first processing department. However, we need to discuss how costs flow from one processing department to the next. So in our example, we were talking about ski masks, and we talked about how costs are in the shaping process, that first department, and how they work, how they're allocated to each unit produced. However, what happens when those costs are transferred from the first department to a second or future processing department? So it's slightly different, and we're going to see how that works. So we've discussed the shaping process. Now we need to discuss how that cost comes down from the shaping department into the insertion process, as well as additional direct materials and direct labor and manufacturing overhead being applied to that second process, eventually giving us a finished product or a completed mask. So let's look at our timeline for the insertion department. So we have our transferred in cost from shaping. So we have those 40,000 units that came from our shaping department that were completed and transferred out of shaping, transferred in to the insertion department. We again see how our conversion costs are added evenly throughout the production process. And we see how eventually 38,000 masks were completed and transferred out of the insertion department into finished goods. We can also see from our timeline here that we have 7,000 masks that have been started but still not yet completed that are remaining in our ending work in process. And those units are 30% complete as to conversion. They are 0% complete as to direct materials, because as we can see on our timeline, direct materials are being added at the end of the insertion process. So if we look at our output in terms of equivalent units, we find that first let's focus on direct materials and conversion, since that's what we know at this point. Completed and transferred out, they were 100% complete as to materials and conversion. So all 38,000 that were transferred out are equivalent units as to materials and conversion. Ending work in process, there was 7,000 units there. Direct materials being added at the end of the process, therefore there are 0 equivalent units as to materials. And they were a certain percent complete as to conversion, 30% complete as to conversion. Therefore, 2,100 units are equivalent units as to conversion. Now notice in the transferred in column, they're all equivalent units as to transferred in cost. What we need to know is if a cost is being transferred in from a prior processing department, those costs are considered 100% complete as to transferred in cost, because that transferred in cost is being added at the beginning of the process. So all units, whether completed and transferred out or still in ending work in process, are considered 100% complete with respect to transferred in work and costs.